Welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we are going to design this captain wheel, and we will talk about the bezel setting right in the middle and also the bead setting around the rim. Are you ready? Let's get started. I have a stone setting course. If you're interested more about the stone setting than just a bezel set, you can check it out. You can click over here on the right top corner. I will have a link over there. We are going to starting with a center stone for whatever size that you like. If you want to know how to make the stone, I have a video here on my YouTube channel to building a stone from scratch. Now we have this stone and we need to make a C for it. To making a C, we simply just going to make a rectangle, and you can have the rectangle in any of the size that you want, but be really important is you need to make sure that the stone is not cutting over 50% of the wall thickness. I usually like to keep it about 20 to 30%, and so that way that will set the stone better. And what I wanted to do is also draw a line and follow my stone, roughly go like this way and then going up like this, and using that curve to trim off this area here, and again using this curve to trim the extra over there, and I simply can just join them together. So now this is the curve that I have. I always get the question like how much metal I need to leave over there. As long as you are over the table area, you should be fine. However, if you are not so sure, you can always make it a bit longer, which is actually better for you. If you don't have enough metal, you can just if you have it too much extra, and you can just file it down. Make sure that the kulak is not sticking out from the bottom. You want to leave at least 0.5 millimeter or more. That way your stone won't accidentally set it too low and the kulak is kind of stick out from the bottom. Alright, to make a bezel, we simply just gonna use the revolve, and this will be the curve, and we're gonna snap it into the zero as our axis, and then we're gonna revolve 360 degrees, and then we will get the center like that. If this is going to be your rendering, you probably don't want to do that. It's because this is look really sharp. For the rendering purpose, I will suggest you go it much lower and something look like this. And you want to round it the edges. Let's give it a small fillet for 0.4 millimeter. And you want to fit it here, and you also want to fit it there. Okay, and then let me do a comparison for you. We are going to use the same command, and let's use a revolve, snapping into the zero, 360 degrees, and then we get that there. Let's do a comparison by moving this one to the side, and we want to use the render view for this. As you can see, this one on the edge look much nicer. This one is really sharp, so this one will look much better on the render if you round the corner like that. Compared to this one, this is for 3D printing, and we need to have enough room for jeweler to file the extra metal. So since we are planning to 3D printing this, I'm going to have this one stay like that. The next step is we need to decide it where the bead setting is going to be. So I'm going to draw a circle and roughly about this size. I'm gonna set it the stone. It's about, let's go ahead to draw the circle first to show where the stone is going to be. And then I want the stone is right on the top. I plan to have 1.3 millimeter stone. So we are going to use the offset command, and we're gonna offset this curve for 0.75. and we want it on both sides, so you get something like that. You should have a space in between here. It's about 1.5, and that will be for enough of our 1.3 millimeter stone. Now bring in the stone in the right size, and we are going to arrange the stone on it. I'm going to try with the array along the curve, and we are going to pick up this object, and we're gonna hit the base curve. Let's try 36 and see how it goes. And it actually looked pretty well, I guess, right at the first time. Alright, so now we need to work on the prong. I'm coming over to the side view, and I'm gonna draw something somewhere right in the middle, something going like this, and this will be my curve. I'm gonna move this curve to somewhere about here, and we're simply just going to pipe it. Let's pipe it with the diameter for 0.55 and see how it look on it. Alright, so it looks okay, and let's see if we can cover both of the stone right there, and then just cutting a little bit about the stone. Alright, it looked nice to me, and I'm going to making a copy and make sure that you want to equally place over there as well in between the stone. So once we have this one, we are going to we can simply just using the polar array, or you want to array along the curve. Either one will work. I'm going to try array along the curve and pick up the same base curve and using the same number over there and click on the C plane, and then we will get something like this. Make sure everybody is nice and even. It's not sticking out to the line that we have there. Alright, so I'm going to giving a little bit rim there because it's really close to the stone. So I'm going to offset again for this curve. That's offset it for about 0.4 millimeter, and we're gonna offset this guy for 0.4 millimeter, and now we're gonna use those two and make it into the solid by extruding planar curve straight. And I do like to use both sides as well, and depends on how thick that you want it to be on for the thickness. Now to make it a little bit nicer, we can give in a bevel edge. So we want to use the command that's called chamfer, and I just wanted to have the chamfer edge is the same distance we just set for 0.4 millimeter, and we want to chamfer this one, also the one on the bottom, they all 0.4 millimeters. So now it looks a little bit nicer. Now we can go ahead to design whatever we like over there by drawing the curve, or depends on how complicated you want it. I simply just want to do something like this. I want to draw a straight line and coming to the top for whatever that is going to be, and I'm gonna draw another straight line coming over to here. And sometimes it will not be exactly on the construction plane, so we are going to project to the C plane, and we want to delete the input, so now they are right in the middle. Okay, so let's work on the top first. I simply just gonna use the piping command, and right here is about this size. On the top is a little bit bigger, and somewhere coming into this area is a neck. So it's gonna come in something like this. If this is too big for you, you can just simply just scale it down and move it like that. This one as well, I wanted this one's about this wide, that wide, and go somewhere in the middle. It's about thinner like this, and we get something like this. To keeping the same look but reduce your metal cost, you might want a 1D scale, something like that. So it's not losing the look, but it giving a really good reducing on the metal weight. And we are going to use the command called polar array. We are gonna snapping into the 0 point and number of item for 8, 360 degree, and that's how we get this captain wheel. And all you need to do is to put the bell on the top of it. My new feature for the membership option is coming up really soon. I will talk about a lot of things that is exclusive for member. I hope you will like it. I will announce really soon once it's released. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next.